So the outline of this presentation is presents the purpose of the research. We present the Internet of Things and some learning from that. Present the state of the art and some challenges to overcome. We finally present our proposals and use space for validation and confidence. As an introduction, our purpose is to use physical objects in learning process and find that Internet of Things and learning environments could be enabling technology. However, Internet of Things and learning are two different domains based on several different standards. And so the question is it possible to combine the Internet of Things and learning standards as ELSG and IPE in a coherent and unified manner? The Internet of Things is a paradigm introduced by Tim Ashford in 1999. It is currently more and more used in many applications. It is related to this process completely, and it is used to connect physical objects to the Internet. The new standard of DNSSG is a specification developed by DNSSG, and it enables a formal description of learning process. The central idea with DNSSG is that the process of the scenario of learning is given with activities and interactions between peers or between peers and the children. The experience of me is a new situation, but in the setting, the learning experience. It is based on a learning theory called SOAR, which is a repository that allows to collect one's learner data from a physical or digital learning environment. And it specifically stores data in learning statement format. So as illustrated within the picture, we can capture many learning statements from many environments and store them within the learning store. And this learning record store could be shared between many entities. The state of the art has shown that many works has used the Internet of Things for learning environments. Very few have dealt with ELSG with Internet of Things, and also the experience AE hasn't been used. So our idea is to exploit these merging standards. So the challenges that we are facing is we have a strong requirement to standards for supporting a range of pedagogical scenarios, physical as well as digital, and to adapt these scenarios based on learning target experience. Our proposal deals with three aspects. The first one deals with the extension of the SMB with the Internet of Things, the work of the X18 specification to keep track of the learning experiences, and to adapt the scenarios based on digital information. But the heterogeneity of these standards prevents the combination to take effect. So we need to identify 5 and 7 language to overcome those problems. We find that ontologies are considered as a promising solution. That's why we use ontologies. So for our proposal, we have with the ELSG model, which contains all ELSG concepts and their metadata, and which allow us to describe formally and explicitly learning scenarios. We have also proposed the extension of the ELSG with Internet of Things. So we have extended the learning environment to be smart complexes. We have extended learning complexes to physical learning complexes. And we have extended learning activities to physical activities for allowing interaction with physical objects. This is our attainment of the model, which allocates the inner extension and which includes smart objects into physical learning environment, and the third set of the smart objects profiles. And finally, the XAPE model, which provides XAPE specification concepts and tracks learning experience. For learning all those standards, we need to make some mappings between DNSSD and XAPE and also the Internet of Things concept. So we find that three of these standards have several common concepts. For example, in the Internet of Things concept, we find the learner. In DNSSD, also we can design the learner. And in the XAPE concept, we have the actor, which is XAPE learner. Here is our use case. You consider that Michael, the student in computer science, and he deals with unit of learning for distinguishing between computer building blocks. And we should understand the functionalities. The user components to deal with scenario are computer components, which are physical components, and some mobile devices, which are equipped with NFC modules and augmented objects with NFC tags. The learning activities are to touch the Internet of Things components and to make some assets. The scenario following description, here we have the NSLD scenario with the Internet of Things methodology, and we have decided from the scenario, and we have contextual data which are attractive. As examples, we can clearly apply the NSLD and XAPE ontology. For example, for OSLD, the list of subjects and objects related with the health trend property, and this is clearly for retrieving this kind of information. The example 3 illustrates, for example, an adaptation rule. When Michael does not understand the component and its functionality, he sends a message using his smartphone to an Egmont object. And so the Egmont object will send a hyperlink for such explanation. Finally, as the conclusion, our Egmont Studio e-learning standard with smart objects in certain complex learning scenarios. To keep track of the learning experience, we help user ontologies to grant and totally different standards to provide contextual activities to learners. We aim in the future to expand our ontology with additional rules related to contextual and adaptability, understanding the proposal needs and expand the learning online. Finally, we thank you for your attention and if you have some questions.